Hello guys, we are back with our next lecture. In this lecture, let us go through semantic tabulae system in propositional logic. So basically, till now we done with two methods, right? So those are nothing but natural deduction and axiomatic system. So in those both mechanisms, we used forward chaining approach, guys. Fine? Okay. So here, in this method, we will be using the backward chaining. So that's the reason why this is completely different method. Okay, so in both natural detection and axiomatic system, forward chaining approach is used for constructing the proof and derivation. Although the forward chaining approach is good for theoretical purpose, its implementation in derivation and proof is difficult. So that is the reason why this came into play. So two approaches may be used. Those are nothing but semantic tabulae and resolution reflexuation method. Guys, this we will be discussing in our next lecture, guys. Please don't miss this chapter, this topic, guys. Because in a main resolution topic, you will be discussing about this. So that's the reason why I'm saying, please don't miss this topic, okay? So in this method, we follow backward chaining, yes? Semantic tabulae is a binary tree. So we will be drawing a binary tree. It's constructed by using the semantic tabulae rules with a formula as a root. So here the formula will be given and we will be deriving a tree for it. Fine. Okay. So if it is alpha and b. So guys, I'll be just saying you some tricks. Please remember them, guys. Please. So and means if then this then, right? So you like pen and pencil. So pen, pencil, you want both, right? You like both. So in that situation, you'll be writing one after the other, alpha and beta. So alpha after beta. Okay. So negation of alpha and beta is true if either or is alpha, sorry, and alpha or and alpha is true. Okay. So basically, I hope everyone knows the conversion of this to normal. So after by applying the De Morgan's law, or alpha tends to beta. So here both are negative and the symbol in between is or, right? So if it is or, I told if it and it will be writing one after the other. If it is or, you'll be writing one or other. So if you can select this or this, here you need to select both. Understood the logic? That's it. If you know this logic, you can write any statement, guys. It's just a matter of seconds for you to write. So if it is in between or, you'll be writing separately. If it is in this way, do the operation. And alpha, beta, sorry, negation of beta. So this will, this and this are both are compulsory and means one after the other. Perfect. So negation of alpha is nothing but alpha. So directly alpha. Alpha tends to beta, remember guys. So I hope everyone knows the formula alpha tends to beta can be written as negation of alpha or, sorry, negation of alpha or beta or b. So in this way you'll be writing in between or, so you'll be writing or. Guys, just by the small trick which I have just told you, you'll be applying that, that's it. So similarly for this also, for double implies you'll be having two different, I hope everyone remembers that. So even if you want, you can further divide this also, guys, like branches, fine, okay. So similarly for double implication or negation also same. So I hope everyone got a small idea on this. So now let us go through a small problem so that you'll be having a clear idea. So the given question is this. So he asked us to reduce that into a graph. Okay. Okay. So initially let us take this and this, guys. So this as one, this as two. So I took this whole part here and I took this whole part here. So in between and, right? So and means one after the other. So here I wrote this one after the other. So now we are done till here. So now these two applications is over. So just to close them. So now come from here. So here the between symbol is and. So this after this. So A after B. Okay, so now we are done with this also. So after this you need to do this. So negation of B. So exactly it is starting here, right? So connect them. So negation of B, you need to get a negation of B tends to C. So I told you tends means alpha tends to beta means what I told guys. Negation of alpha or beta, right? So this we will be applying. So negation of B or C. So now we are done till here. So is there any further amplification till here? No. So this is closed and this is also closed. So this is the path, guys. So path in tabular tree extends from the root to the leaves. So there are two paths. Those are nothing but closed and open. Okay. So I hope everyone got a clear idea on this. So in the next lecture, we'll be going to resolution reflexion in propositional logic. Guys, this topic is again covered in first order predicate logic or predicate logic. So that's the reason why I'm just forcing you to watch this lecture, guys. Please because there is a 10 marks question completely based on this concept almost. So let us meet in the next tutorial. Thank you. Thanks for watching.